Hi, in this video, we're going to go over how to read the result log files that you get after importing incidents into the system. For this example, I've gone ahead and imported an incident file called example_incidents.txt. This is the result zip file that I downloaded from the email that I received after I imported the incident file. I already extracted its files into this test-import directory. So let's take a look at those files. I should see a set of 5 files for each incident file that I uploaded to the system. I only uploaded one incident file, so I will only see 5. Each file gives information about the success or errors of the import.
The .bat file includes all those incidents that were not imported due to some error. The .out file is just a copy of the incident file that you uploaded. The parsing error file includes all issues involving file formatting.
For now, we only care about 2 of these files. The file that ends in .log and the file that ends in .error. Let's first take a look at the .log file inside Notepad. At the top of the .log file, you should see basic information about the request itself, such as the incident file that you uploaded, whether you chose to accept your invalid incidents being saved to the system, and whether you chose to overwrite any existing incidents with your own. The next section tells you whether each incident from the incident file was imported successfully, had any validation errors, or outright failed to import. The first line says, incident was successfully imported, followed by the key information for that incident, which includes the incident's associated fire department ID, the associated state, so if this incident was reported in, say, Virginia, it would be VA instead of TR, the incident date, the incident number, and the exposure number. So we know one incident was imported without any errors, but what about the others? The next line says that the incident with this key information contains validation errors. So we know some part of that incident data was invalid. The line after that says the same thing about another incident. This final line says that the incident failed to import. My incident file only contained 4 incidents, but in practice yours could contain many more. So you can expect this list of messages to be much longer than shown here. Under Incident Summary, you will see a count for each type of import. Here we see that one incident was imported successfully, 2 incidents were invalid but imported anyway, and 1 incident failed to import at all. It will then show a total of all the incidents that were processed. And that's the end of the .log file. Let's go back to the zip file contents and now look at the .air file. This is the .air file in Notepad. We know from the .log file that 2 incidents were found invalid. This .air file shows you the actual error messages for those incidents. Each line starts with key information identifying the incident, followed by the module on which the error occurred, then the specific error message itself, then the severity of the error, and finally the field on which the error occurred. This repeats for all error messages for each invalid incident. Ideally, if there are no errors, this file should be empty. And that's the end of the .air file.
If you encounter any errors when importing incidents, you can do the following. You can try to re-import your files, save the .log file as a receipt of your import, make corrections in your vendor software, and lastly, contact your state eNFIRS program manager and the eNFIRS support center for further assistance if you need it.
In this video, we went over how to read the result files from an incident import so that we understand how successful or unsuccessful our incident import was.